हेलो फ्रेंड, टुडे वी हैव टू डिस्कस द सॉलिड डाइइलेक्ट्रिक यूज्ड इन प्रैक्टिसेस इन वेरियस एप्लीकेशंस और इन वेरियस इक्विपमेंट्स और अपैरेटस. द मेजरली यूज्ड इंसुलेटिंग सिस्टम इज सॉलिड एंड दे कैन बी ब्रॉडली क्लासिफाइड इनटू थ्री कैटेगरीज, दैट इज ऑर्गेनिक मटेरियल, इनऑर्गेनिक मटेरियल एंड सिंथेटिक पॉलीमर्स. In that, we have to discuss what are the different types of material involved in each material, that is in the organic, inorganic and synthetic. Here we have to shown what are the different materials involved in the different categories. See, in the organic material, umber, cotton, paper, pasteboard, rubber, wax, wood, these are the different materials are involved. And in the inorganic material, ceramic, glass, mica, asbestos, these are the different types are present. Then in the synthetic polymer, there will be two are present, that is thermoplastic and thermosetting. In the thermoplastic, polyethylene is present, perspex is present, polypropylene is present, polystyrene is present, polyvinyl chloride, polycarbonate is present. And in the thermosetting, the bakelite, epoxy resin, cross-linked polyethylene, phenolics, elastomers and melamin is present. These are the different materials are involved in the synthetic polymers and they are used in the various application. According to the IEC, that is International Electrotechnical Commission, there will be different types of insulating materials are present. That is class Y insulator, that is formally 0, that is 90 degree Celsius, paper, cotton, silk, natural rubber, polyvinyl chloride, ATC without impregnations are used. Then class A insulation, that is 105 degree Celsius, same as class Y, but impregnated and nylons are used. Then class E 120 degree Celsius, that is polyethylene, then terephthalene fiber, melinex fiber film is present, cellulose, polyurethanes, polyvinyl acetate enamels are present. Then class B 130 degree Celsius, that is mica is present. Bituminous materials are used, that is bakelite, polyester enamels are used. Then class F 155 degree Celsius, same as class B, but with alkyd and epoxy based resins are used. In class H 180 degree Celsius, these materials same as the class B with silicon resin binder, silicon rubber, aromatic polyamide, polyamide film and esteramide enamels are present. Then class C above 180 degree Celsius, it will be same as B but with the suitable non-organic binders are used. Then here Teflon and other high temperature polymers are used and subgroup in class C are 200 degree Celsius to 220 degree Celsius and 250 degree Celsius and above materials are used at various temperature materials are used. We have to discuss related to the solid dielectrics types, that is used in various applications. That is paper and boards, fibers, mica and its products, glass, ceramic, rubber, plastic, polyethylene, fluorocarbon, nylon and polyvinyl chloride, polyester and epoxy resin. Then we have to discuss details about the different material. That is, first one is paper and board. The kind of paper normally employed for insulation purpose is a special variety known as tissue paper and craft paper. paper and paper boards used for dielectric purpose are produced from cotton, organic fibers, mica, glass and ceramic. Generally, if the thickness of the paper is 0.5 micron or higher, it is called as paper board. Board of higher thickness are made by laminating many layers of paper with an adhesive to get the desired thickness. These are called as a press board and are used in the transformer bushing as a supporting material and insulating barriers. The thickness and density of paper vary depending on the application. Low density paper is preferred in high frequency capacitors and cable, while medium density paper is used in the power capacitor, and high density paper are preferably used in DC and energy storage capacitors and for the insulation of DC machine. These are the different types of papers according to thickness we have to, or according to density we have to used for the various applications. Second one is the fiber. Fiber when used for electrical purpose will have ability to combine strength and durability with extreme fitness and flexibility, and the fiber used are both the natural and man-made. Fiber includes the cotton, jute, flax, wool, silk, rayon, nylon, terephthalene, teflon, fiberglass. These are the different types of material are involved in the fibers and they are used in the various applications. And the property of the fibrous material is mainly or dependent on the temperature and humidity. Third one is the mica and its product. Mica is the generic name of the class of crystalline minerals, silicate of aluminium and potash. And they are classified in four types: muscovite, phlogopite, and phibolite, and lipodolite. And the last two groups are hard and brittle. Hence, it will be unsuitable for electrical insulation purpose. Mica can be split into various thin, flat lamination. And it has got a unique combination of electrical properties such as high dielectric strength, low dielectric losses and resistance to high temperature and good mechanical strength. This have made it possible for it to be used in many electrical apparatus. Very pure mica is used for high frequency applications, and spotted mica is used for low voltage insulation such as commutator segment separator, armature winding, switchgear, and in electrical heating and cooling equipments. One is the glass. Glass is a thermoplastic inorganic material comprising complex system of oxides. The solid dielectrics used in practice, constant of glass varies from 3.7 to 10, and the density varies from 2.2 to 6 gram per centimeter cube. At room temperature, the volume resistivity of glass varies from 10 raised to 12 to 10 raised to 20 ohm centimeter. The solid dielectrics used in practice, that is loss of glass, varies from 0.004 to 0.020 depending on the frequency. The losses are highest at lower frequency, and the dielectric strength of glass varies from 3000 to 5000 kilovolt per centimeter and decrease with increase in temperature, reaching half the value at 100 degree Celsius. Glass is used as a cover and for internal support in electric bulb, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक वॉल, मर्क्यूरी आर्क स्विचेस, एक्सरे इक्विपमेंट, कैपेसिटर एंड एज ए इंसुलेटर इन टेलीफोन्स. देन नेक्स्ट वन इज़ द सिरेमिक. सिरेमिक इज इनऑर्गेनिक मटेरियल प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय कंसोलिडेटिंग मिनरल्स इनटू मोनोलिथिक बॉडीज बाय हाई टेम्परेचर हीट ट्रीटमेंट. सिरेमिक कैन बी डिवाइडेड इनटू टू ग्रुप डिपेंडिंग ऑन द सॉलिड डाइलेक्ट्रिक्स यूज्ड इन प्रैक्टिस कॉन्स्टेंट. द लो परमिटिविटी सिरेमिक आर यूज्ड एज ए इंसुलेटर while high permittivity ceramics are used in capacitors and transducers. Sixth one is the rubber. Rubber is a natural or synthetic vulcanizable high polymer, high elastic properties. Electrical properties of rubber depending on the degree of compounding and vulcanizing. Generally impurities and chemical changes due to the aging, moisture content, variation in temperature and frequency have sustainably effects on the electrical properties of the rubber. Then seventh one is the plastic. Plastic used for electrical insulation purpose consists of long chain macromolecules with repeating monomer units. A polymer is named by putting the prefix poly in front of monomer. For example, propylene monomer becomes polypropylene. Some of the polymers used in the current insulation practice are polyethylene, PTFE, PVC, polypropylene, polystyrene. These are the actually used polymers in the practices. Then next one is polyethylene. Polyethylene is a thermoplastic material which combines unusual electrical properties, high resistance to the moisture and chemical, easy processability, low cost. It has got high resistivity and good dielectric properties at high frequency, and therefore it is widely used for polymers used in current insulation. It is also used in the power and coaxial cables, telephone cables, multi-conductor control cables, TV lead-in wires, etc. Next one is the fluorocarbon plastics. The fluorotetrafluoroethylene, that is PTFE, and polychlorotrifluoroethylene, that is PCTFE, polyvinylidene, that is PVF2. Plastics comes under this category. The PTFE is mostly thermally stable and chemical resistance of all the threes. It is considered as one of the best plastic used for insulation because of its excellent electrical and mechanical properties. It can be used without decomposition up to temperature of 327 degrees Celsius. It is widely used in almost all applications. PCTFE has higher dielectric constant and loss factor than PTFE, but melts at 190 degrees Celsius, and PVF2 can be worked in temperature range 30 degrees Celsius to 150 degrees Celsius. It is used as a thin wall insulator, as a jacketing for computer wires, spatial control wires, and for tubing, sleeving for capacitors, resistor, terminal junction and solder sleeves. Next one is nylon. Nylon is a thermoplastic which possesses high impact, tensile flexifluoro strength over wide range of temperature. It also has high dielectric strength. good surface and volume resistivity even after a lengthy exposure to high humidity. It is also a resistance to a chemical action and can be easily molded and machined. It is generally recommended for high frequency, low loss application. In electrical engineering, nylon molding are used for make coil form, fasteners, connectors, washers, cable clamp, switch housing, etc. Next one is polyvinyl chloride. Polyvinyl chloride or PVC is used commercially in various forms. It is available as a unplastic sized top and rigid sheet material and can be easily shaped to any required form. Polyvinyl chloride is chemically resistant to strong acid, alkalis, and it is insoluble in water, alcohol, and organic solvent like as benzene. The upper temperature limit of operation is about 60 degrees Celsius. The dielectric strength, volume resistivity, surface resistivity are relatively high. The solid dielectrics used in practice constant, and loss tangents are 3.0 to 3.3 and 0.015 to 0.02 respectively at all frequencies up to 1 megahertz. Then next one is the polyester. Polyester have excellent dielectric properties, a superior surface hardeners, and are highly resistant to most chemical. They represents a whole family of thermosetting plastic produced by the concentration of tricarboxylic acid and dihydric alcohol and are classified as either saturated or unsaturated types. Unsaturated polymers are used in glass laminates, glass fibers, reinforced molding, and both of which are widely used for making small electrical components to very large structures. The saturated polymers are used in producing fibers and films. The polyester fibers is used to make papers, map, cloth for electrical application, and the film is used for insulating wires and cables in motor, capacitors, and transformer. Next one is the epoxy resin or thermosetting type of insulating material. They possesses excellent dielectric and mechanical properties. They can be easily cast into desired shape even at room temperature. They are versatile and their basic properties can be modified either by the selection of curing agent or by the use of modifier or fillers. Thank you, friend. These are the different types of insulating materials are used as a in various applications in the electrical apparatus and the equipment. Thank you.